guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Pragya Gautam and yes, I'm sitting in my patio and I'm filming here because Nirvi is sleeping and Nimish is working in one room. So yeah, I'm out here and in today's video, I'm going to share with you all that how I sleep trained Nirvi. She's now 16 months old, but yes, I trained her when she was 12 months old and it was quite late. I should have trained her when she was just 6 or 7 months, but why I didn't, I'll tell you in little bit. So yeah, stay tuned. We teach our children how to eat, how to walk, how to crawl. This is the thing what we should also introduce to your baby, that how to sleep and how to self-soothe, because it's important for them to learn how to go back to sleep if they are awake and if they are tired. And also it's important for their mind development and for their body development, for entire growth. But so many of my relatives and my friends were like, how she is sleeping all alone and how she is sleeping throughout the night and without disturbing you guys, and that too she is sleeping on her crib. I was quite happy with that questions, and I just wanted to answer all of you, and I also wanted to help you guys, those who those who are struggling with these things. And yes, I'm here with the help. Let's get into the topics quickly. I'm going to share one thing, that why I delayed this sleep training, because for 3 months we were in India, so she was co-sleeping with me and she got this bad habit of sleeping with me. And I'm sorry, because she was a very good baby. She was sleeping on her crib and she was all scheduled and all. So yeah, after coming back from India, it was so hard for me to soothe her in the night, and she always wanted the breast milk to soothe herself. And she was also waking up more frequently, and she was waking up more than 6 to 7 times in a night, and it was really frustrating for me, because you have to be active in the morning as well, because yeah, that's the life and you have to be active with a baby. So yeah, then I thought I have to sleep train her. So I applied the Ferber method, that is a cry out method, on Nirvi. And before doing that also, I consulted her pediatrician, that is it a good time and should I do this or not. And he was like, until and unless she is just not throwing up and she is not coming out of her crib, and if she is not harming herself, it's okay, let them cry for 1 hour or 2 hours, it's fine, they cry. And I was like, okay, I have got a green flag and now I can start training her. And after her first birthday, I did this thing. So I'm going to tell you in the point how to start and from where to start. It's very good to sleep train them as early as possible, in between 6 to 7 months. It's the perfect time. After that also you do, it's okay, but yeah, I'm just telling that what's the good time to start. And after 6 months, any point of time when you think that I should start now, it's a good time. So yeah, it's never too late. So here I am with the schedule what I followed with Nirvi. And also you need to stick to that particular schedule for 3 to 4 days at least, to make sure that they are understanding this thing. Because my doctor told me that whatever you do with your baby for 3 to 4 days, they they kind of get into it, and this is how their brain also set time for them. So yeah, make sure you're sticking really well to the schedule. So yeah, this schedule takes 1 to 1.5 hour to complete. So between 7:30 to 8:45, I make sure that I'm completing all the scheduled things. So make sure first of all that your baby has played enough in the evening and they are really tired, they have played really well, they were outside or inside, whatever, they had played enough. First thing, after playing with her a lot and after making her tired completely, so I first give her dinner at 7:30. And at 7:30 means 7:30, I used to stick to that particular time. 7:30 to 8 she used to have her dinner, and at 8 I used to give her bath, water bath, and it takes 15 minutes. And then again after 8:15 to 8:30, between that time I used to give her massage. just dress them and make sure their diaper is all dry, and just feed them for a little. And if you're a breastfeeding mom, then you can just breastfeed. And now my baby is grown up, so I give her bottle, so make sure they are having anything just to soothe themselves. Now the challenging part comes, that you have to hear your child crying a lot. Trust me, but this is going to be worth, because they are going to cry only for 3 to 4 days. After just saying good night to your baby, just dim the light and close the door and go back to your work. They are going to sleep very well, and also you are going to sleep very well. So it's time to hear them cry for at least 35-45 minutes. So the main thing is for how long you need let them cry. So according to my doctor, if your baby is crying for 1 or 2 hours, it's fine, completely fine if they cry a lot. If you can't bear your baby crying and all, just put headphones on. This is the best thing what I did. I used to put my headphones on. The first day what you have to do is check them in 45 minutes or 30 minutes, and after that let them cry. And if they want you to cuddle them, and if they want you to hold them and anything sort of this, don't do anything. Don't hold them, don't cuddle with them, just don't even do shh also, because they'll get the habit of that as well. That was the wrong thing what I did. So don't shh, make any kind of sound or anything. Just go and pet their back and just make sure they're okay, and go back to your work and again close the door. That's the only thing you can do. And after that, again check back in 30 minutes, do the same thing, and do the and after 15 minutes again check back and do your thing. And in first day they'll go back to sleep in between 1 to 1.5 hours for sure. And they may take longer time as well if your baby is really cranky. And in the second day you have to follow the same schedule and same thing with the crying, but in this day you have to check them in the longer duration and for the less time. I mean, you put them on bed and check after 45 minutes, and after that you check on again 30 minutes, but just see them and come back, see them and come back, and just let them know that you are there in the house. That's it, nothing else. So continue these things for 3 to 4 days, and definitely your baby going to sleep really well in 3 to 4 days. I'm pretty sure, because my baby, she was really bad after coming from India in sleeping, and now she has started sleeping. So yes, if my baby can do, your baby can also do. To be honest, you're going to need lots of patience and lots of consistency with these things to make sure that you're following all these schedules and the method and all. So yes, I wish you all the best, and I wish you lots and lots of patience. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you found this video really helpful. If you are struggling with this thing, make sure you are sharing with other women and other moms as well, would be moms soon or new moms, because this is a really helpful video, I could say, on my channel. So yeah, make sure you are just spreading this video a lot. Hit on the like button, subscribe to my channel. As I come with a lot of videos, and yes, and I'll see you guys in my next one. But till then, please follow me on social media. I'm really active, so yeah.